Huntington disease. Actually, the scenario came that there is a father recently diagnosed by Huntington disease, and he will talk to the daughter to explain to her the condition of the father and offering the genetic testing as well. So you should start by asking the daughter if she is the next of kin. If in the scenario the patient is conscious, ask her if she has a permission to discuss the condition of her father with her. And start telling her that the results have been done for your father, show that he has a disease called Huntington, and explain your story about that her father is recently diagnosed by this disease, and inquire if any of her family members have this similar symptom or this disease before. It's very important early to cover these two items in any genetic counseling station. The family tree. Try to ask about the family tree early by asking about the number of the sisters, the brothers, aunts, uncles, cousins. This will be very important. And ask if they have a partner, and offering if the partner can attending the counseling. This will be very important in the early to give a good impact on the examiner as well. When you start to explain the disease, try to deal with this as a breaking bad news. And as all the disease, you have to cover the definition and the symptom and the investigation and the complication and the treatment as well. In the definition, it's very important to explain the disease affecting the brain tissue or brain cell and sometimes led to damage and affecting many functions of the brain. At this time, try to draw the brain, try to give example of some function which will be affected. In the definition as well, you have to cover the autosomal dominant inheritance mode and tell that the patient or children have 50% chance to get the disease for everyone. You have to mention the anticipation that the new generation or the future generation more liable to get the disease earlier and more severe form. When you cover the clinical picture and the complication and the investigation, mention in briefly and in summary as much as you can, but when you came to the treatment and the plan of management, don't forget to mention that it's untreatable condition, but the symptom can be controlled by regular follow-up and observation. Social history very fast, and in the social history, you have to recommend two things, that the patient shouldn't go out alone because of the dementia, and should avoid to be fall and get injury or trauma. This is very important point to be covered during your explanation of the disease. When you finish, ask about the advanced directive and the last power of attorney. We will come in details to this issue and the offering the palliative care as well. Then explain of the procedures, which here is the genetic testing. As usual, you will cover all the element of any procedures, but you start by tell the patient that we will offer to you a predictive genetic testing, which explain to her more that is different from the diagnostic testing done for your father, and mentions that you need blood test sample to be taken from her and do some scanning or imaging for her brain and make some assessment psychologically for her and some family member and her father as well. Start by explanation of genetic testing that you will mention the patient of the family member, if you take the family tree, below 18 years old, will not be candid to do the test. And also mention the multidisciplinary team, including the laboratories, which will be the one who will do the test, and the result will be sent confidentially to the patient. Mention the other multidisciplinary team, like the brain specialist doctor, social worker, psychiatrist, someone trained in the medical ethics. Don't ever forget in the multidisciplinary team, the gene specialist, who is the one who will explain the consent and take the consent from the patient, and discuss the implication of the result on the insurance and the career and the family member as well. For the confidentiality coverage, you have to tell her that the result will be confidentially for her only. But here also, the very important point you asked earlier, the partner. Actually, the patient, if he refuse and denies that he have a problem like that, you should offering breaching of the confidentiality. So for any genetic test, asking the patient to inform the family member and the partner, And if the patient disagree at the time, you should offer breach confidentiality. After that, informed consent should be discussed. You have to mention the items, fixed items of the consent, and you can tell, give her that you will take time. And if she refuses offering, that she can submit her genetic material to be used in the future. And about the result, tell her that it can be predicted both, to be affected, which mean positive. But at that time, tell her we can tell you what exactly the age your septum will appear and what the degree and severity the septum can you have. And if she predicted not affected, which mean negative, ensure or reassure her that she will not pass her genetic material to her children. So starting with the fixed concern and the question from the surrogate at that station, he will ask you, it's treatable, doctor? No, it's untreatable, but septum can be controlled by regular follow-up and observation. Doctor, I will be indisable like my father. At that time, you have to mention the anticipation, even you mentioned before. This concern is came for anticipation. I'm really sorry to tell you the septum will can come earlier and more severe for you and maybe for the next generation of your family as well. But be sure this is the bad idea. Tell her a good idea or good news. But be sure that we will give you full care and maximum support as much as we can. Inform, and no one can know what can happen in the future. Maybe we can get researches and go on and we can find out some medication and treatment for your disease in the future. She will ask you, can I inform? I have to inform my husband, doctor. Tell her, yes, you should. She will tell you, if I'm negative, can I infect my or get the disease for my children? Tell her, if you're negative, you will not pass the genetic material to your children. She will ask you about the chance for her brother and sister. Tell her, actually, I'm sorry, I can't exactly tell you what age they will be affected and what the degree and or the severity they will be on. If she's pregnant, she will ask you, what I can do, doctor, and how can I will be affected? Tell her, there is a multidisciplinary team will be involving a woman doctor for you. Try not to go through more details at that time, but if she insists, tell her we will offering for you, diagnosing for your baby by taking cavernous chronic villi sample or venous sampling, or doing prenatal testing, or to do selection by if she is planning to get pregnant by sperm bank or ova bank and do IVF as well.